What's up, everybody? It's your boy.
I am
Quartet.
I'm Ebony.
Yo, you look like a joke. I'm tired of the greatest me. You look like you sing for the five blind boys of Alabama. What is
I'm too close.
You suck.
Yo, I tried to save you from yourself. I literally just tried to save you.
Welcome to another explosive episode of the Culture Sexual Podcast. Don't forget to subscribe to our Fans of the Culture Network YouTube channel. Check out the Culture Section Podcast on Spotify, Amazon, and Apple Podcasts. Hold up.
Who looked just like me on television telling us how horrible the country is. Then when they finish with their little spiel, they go get on their jets and fly off to their yachts and enjoy their caviar and champagne and got you out there in the streets marching. You have to be wiser than that. You have to be wiser than that. If it's just that bad, how did Oprah make it? But let me say this. 35 and 40, 45, and in this day and time now, I don't want to offend anybody, but it's probably too late, man, because everybody's probably offended. They're so easy to get offended. Look at them. They're offended on Facebook now. Look at them. I'm offended. It's a good thing that. Do they have an offended emoji? Offended. Go and mash the offended button. But if in this day and time you end up at 34, 35, 40, 45, 50, and you're arguing for a minimum wage at $15 an hour, that's what you're arguing about. And you working at McDonald's. Now, you did something wrong.
Bruh.
You did it. Because at that age, those jobs were never designed to raise a family on. Those jobs were designed for high schoolers. They were not designed for you to raise four children on. Working unless you're the manager, they're not designed for that. Right. Why? Because people aren't going to pay but so much for a hamburger. See, because there ain't but so many ways you can make it. You can make it the beef with lettuce, tomatoes, and onions, or you can change it and put onions, lettuce, tomato, and beef. Just rearrange it and call it something else. Then you really fool the people. Throw a slice of bacon in there. And then you know what? We're going to really sell you something new. We're going to sell you the same thing with three slices. But there ain't but so many ways you can make a hamburger. And there's not but so much you can charge for. So in economics, there is the cost of a thing versus the price of a thing. And in business, the business owner has to weigh the cost with the price. Then he's got to pay his crew. And if you set the cost of a thing too high, where you got to raise the price of a thing, then ain't nobody gonna have a job because they're gonna go out of business. Because you know why? You are not going to pay but so much for a hamburger, for a wing dinner.
The most important video since the I Have a Dream speech.
Hey, man.
It's about a hamburger, right?
Yo, man.
You can say it's about
listen,
the hamburger. But
listen, your actions right now is as worse as them shades you was wearing. And you have a whole bunch of better shades than what you was wearing. Listen, this about man is telling y'all.
How dare you?
This man is saying to y'all that first of all, he said, McDonald's, Burger King, Hardee's, fast food, period.
Yes, sir.
Those jobs was not created for you to raise a family.
Yes, sir.
He said, if you're working there and you think you're going to raise your family off that salary, you're pretty much stupid. He said, those jobs was...
High school job.
He just see, you just agreed with everything he just said. He said it was a high school job.
Wait a minute.
I was.
And then he said this right here.
Yeah.
Then the man said, people ain't going to pay but so much money for a hamburger. Because there's only certain ways you're going to get it. And guess what? Ebony should know that because I say if I go to McDonald's, I have a max price that I want to pay.
Yes, sir.
For two people.
Yes.
For me and her.
Yeah.
My price is $10. I do not want to go to McDonald's and spend over $10 for two people. There is nothing at McDonald's that I need to be spending over $10 for.
Yo, why is he over here?
And then the great bishop, Pastor
Woody. He was spending $30 by himself.
You said he going to spend $30 by himself. You see the shade over there, man.
Look, man, when I talk about somebody put the hammer down,
yeah, man,
put the hammer down, man. Hammer time, man. Hey, can you? Here's the thing.
The shade.
Here's the other sad part. The only people who typically work at McDonald's, right? From what I see, is probably high schoolers and felons.
I don't know, man. If you go to McDonald's during the daytime,
well, I know you see.
I mean, ain't trying to be mean, but you see nothing but a bunch of Mexicans and tore down black people.
Got it. Now here's
and the funny thing is most of them is female black women.
They coming for you.
They
actually is female Hispanic women.
They be managers.
I didn't mean to say Mexicans. I want to say Hispanics.
I understand.
Yeah, man. Hispanics. And it's mostly female.
But we not proud of Proud Boys, so I would think they would understand what you're saying.
And then it's a old black man doing all the janitor work in the lobby.
Now
you heard what the man said. If you a grown adult, and you working at McDonald's,
yes, sir,
you did something wrong somewhere. And you just said felons.
Yeah, that's the thing, though. When I was watching the first 48, right? Just you remember the first 48, the show?
It still come on, don't it?
I think it still come on.
Like you still remember.
It was still season 5, and this guy, he had got out of jail. He'd been on the straight and narrow.
Wait a minute. The first 48?
Yeah.
I didn't know they showed people getting out of jail. I thought it was just...
No. I was just telling the backstory.
Oh, okay.
So this guy had got out of jail. He was doing the right thing. He was working. When I seen him in his outfit...
Oh, boy.
When I seen him I think he might have worked at McDonald's or Hardee's or somewhere like that. I literally thought about this video. Because at the end of the day, right, you know how the prison system got this... It's really about rehabilitation.
So they say.
But then, like, if you're really trying to do the right... Okay, you made a mistake. You do your time in prison. But you come out, you trying to reunite with your kids, and you trying to get a job and all this kind of stuff. This your only option is McDonald's, Hardee's, or churches, right? You'll never break even. That might be your only opportunity.
True.
And I'm just telling you, when you sit back and think about this stuff, man, now you've been in jail 15 years. You about 42, and your manager is 17.
Hey, man.
See,
do what you gotta do.
The man said,
"Of course,
if you a grown adult
went wrong somewhere,
you did something wrong somewhere." And guess what? My thing is, it ain't society's fault, man. It ain't my fault.
It's your fault.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
I mean, you can blame whoever. Fault. I was raised right here. Sorry to hear that.
My daddy wasn't there.
Yeah, I'm.
My mama was on crack.
Still, can I get a number? No, watch this. I want the dollar menu. Can I get two McDoubles with no onions, add mayonnaise, and a large fry?
That'll be $17.18.
I'm good. I'll go to Walmart and buy my own meat.
And here's the other thing that you can't look at either. If you, okay, say you're a black business owner, right? You know how they always say we don't pay on time? You know how to, you know the stereotype.
Stereotype.
But here's the thing. This is the thing, though. You're a black business owner. You're trying to hire black people. You're trying to just say you're trying to build up on the community.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna be honest with you. If you got a small business and that minimum wage go up to $15 an hour, and you got some people that's been working with you for like 3-4 years, you ain't gonna be able to afford that $27.50.
Listen, man, you heard
glasses
what?
Glasses got medicine in them.
Huh?
Those glasses got medicine in them.
Listen, he said what he said, and the first thing you want to ask is, do them glasses got medicine in them?
That made me so bad at the shade.
You want to hear something funny? You want to hear two things before I get to this.
I want to try more.
You know what makes me laugh is this.
I might pretend.
How do they put medicine in glasses?
I
grew up hearing people say that. What medicine do they actually put in the glasses? There's no medicine. Them things have to be like...
I got you off subject.
There's no medicine. They don't put no drops or no pills in it.
The lens.
Yeah, man. It's like It's like microscopes or something, right? It's got to be.
When you said that, you know the little eyedropper thing?
Yeah, man.
All I seen was you put it in the thing, suck it up, and then you put it on the lens.
Ain't no medicine and no glasses. Ain't no medicated glasses. Number two, how you going to do? Hey, those are medicated. Number two, the great bishop. Get back on subject. She want to try on your glasses so bad. Why don't y'all do a glasses swap now? I bet you if y'all do a glasses swap, he'll look like our grandfather with those glasses on.
Oh, my God.
Because those...
First of all, I ain't going to be able to fit them glasses in my head too big. This is the reason why I got these glasses here on.
Number two, the great Bishop Pastor Wooten told y'all,
hilarious,
if they do raise it, these businesses going out of business.
Oh, my God.
He said people only going to pay a certain amount of money for a beggar.
You thought you owned 3 Amazon trucks. Let this thing go up to $15 an hour. You're gonna be riding around half a truck.
I don't know, man. I'm sorry, man. I might disagree with that one. Women be shopping. Amazon is still gonna be flourishing.
Until the warehouse workers say, "Oh, it went up to 15. Well, we need $27.50 an hour." And they like, gracious, they laid off 22,000 people.
I was telling them yesterday morning, I had the same conversation at my job. Mm-hmm. I said, if they move minimum wage to $15, guys here are going to literally say, hey, so minimum wage is $15. How much more was we making above minimum wage? Imagine they getting paid $18.50.
Mm-hmm.
Minimum wage now is $7. So that means $11 increase.
Good.
So now it's 15. Right? You do the 11, you get 26. So I need to be at 26.50 now.
Exactly. See, this right here, when you think about that $15, I'm gonna tell you, man. Maybe $9. You know, maybe $9.
Yeah, I was like a few dollars.
Because I'm just telling you, because you're gonna get into some icky. And they think because we disagree with the minimum wage, they think we're not progressive. Think we just looking at the whole picture.
Yeah, man.
For everyone.
People only just see $15.
Yeah.
They don't see the price of everything going up.
At the end of the day, if you ain't careful, that $15, you live in low income, that jump might mess around and jump up to about $87.52. You're like, man, that's my whole little...
I'm one of them dummies.
You one of them dummies? I know you was. Yeah, $15.
Don't do it. Don't do it.
Watch this, taxes. Good night, man. It's going to be bizarre. This man told y'all these other people is living good, getting on their airplanes.
Come on, man.
And got y'all marching on the streets.
I'm protesting the streets. Beyonce said, look at them dummies.
Getting on their private jets and their yachts. Yeah.
Jay-Z, he named the album because, man, my best album is Reasonable Doubt. Look at them dummies.
Yeah. They ain't up. Yeah. Matter of fact, guess what? They probably will vote for y'all. Yeah, give them that 15.
Hey, some quartet singer saying, man, I gotta get, oh, I see what they doing. I still gotta get this program. Look at them dummies. Hey, nobody cares, man.
Hey, man. They better start caring because guess what? If everything goes up, who gonna go to the quartet events when you can't afford gas?
They barely.
You know how you
that.
Used to can say, you remember how they used to say, hey, can I get $3 on pump one? Uh-huh. And you know they give you a taste. Now $3 won't even give you nothing.
Not even
a gallon.
Nothing.
How much is the milk?
No, sir.
$14.18.
Oh, that baby can drink water.
Thank you.
Exactly.
Water
you remember,
ain't never
heard sugar of milk. I mean, sugar cereal, whatever you call it, man. We're going to take it right back to
I'm
that.
Trying to tell you, man, prices is going to be crazy.
Sheesh.
They better sit at the house and shut up.
And think about all of the cheap stuff you order.
You laughing?
Think about all the cheap stuff you order off, like, Amazon. Just look, $11 cent, $12
cent.
eBay. Watch this. Imagine how much Amazon Prime is going to be.
Yeah, exactly. It's already up there.
Netflix is going to be $50.
Man. I hate to have to give somebody
streaming
some money for using it.
Go up the...
Yeah, Wi-Fi is going to be, watch this, for just the basic slow one, 120.
Sheesh.
And then when
it's
the dude,
terrible.
And then when the dude come install it, he laughing. Man, this is going to be $287.
And here Joe Biden, this is what y'all American people wanted.
Well,
I did what y'all wanted.
Why'd you sound like Trump?
Yeah, I can't really do Biden's voice. Biden, you know, he talks kind of like robotish a little bit.
Yeah.
He talks slow and I can't really do it. Can you do it?
No, I ain't listening enough to do it. I might be.
I'm gonna start watching Saturday Night Live. They'll get it down pat.
Yeah, they will.
And Kamala Harris sounds like a black man. Go on though. Your whole thing is what?
Jesus Christ! The shade on that. We gonna get us canceled.
Hey, if you look at her like at a quick glance, she looks like she's a bodybuilder. Go on though.
She like a teacher to me.
Sure.
Like she look like she a college professor.
She look like she could be on RuPaul's Drag Race. Go on, though.
I don't know what's going
next.
On right now.
I don't either. And I don't want none of this. What's happening? You can have all the smoke. The dude is not on camera and saying the cruelest stuff. Hey, but here's the funny part. They say, this is what we want. No, ass is what we want. Because, see, it's easy to sit back and say, oh, yeah, you know, the poor middle class. Yeah, listen, we could get $10, $9, you know. We ain't talking about 15.
Yeah, 15, man.
It's a lot.
And then on top of that, you forgot about this, too. Before they go out of business, they normally do what? They lay people off.
Yeah.
For
they
sure.
They reduce their hours.
Yeah. They matter of fact, they start with the reduced hours. They hoping when they reduce the hours, some people quit. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, kind of save them so they can get unemployment.
Yeah.
And then, you know, worst case scenario, they start firing. Most of the time, they fire the person who's making the most money. You know, as far as employee, they be like, well, you know, he's making, man, he's
about to retire.
Yeah.
John, we're making some changes. We're making some changes at the company.
Man, sorry.
I know you've been with us 19 and a half.
Guess what? They probably don't even give them nice speeches no more. They probably do it via email.
Ooh, that's
through company email.
That's cold blooded.
You know what I'm saying?
That's cold blooded.
Send you your package.
It's like breaking up with a woman through text message.
Sometimes it's the best way to break up with one.
Is she a killer?
Yeah, man, crazy. Especially if she a black woman. Period. She could be the nicest person, but she's black. You say to yourself, man, we text. Matter of fact, if you shacking up or got some stuff over there, you know, softly, you know, little bit by little bit, take it away. You know what I'm saying? Would she be asking? Where is such and such at? It broke. You know, if it's material things. If it's clothes, be like, it need to be washed. It was dirty. You know what I'm saying? And then after you move the stuff that you really love out, that's when you text her. Be like,
how dare you?
This ain't working.
And let's take some of this fire over here to my right. Ebony, now that we have a female black vice president, how close is she to becoming your role model?
Probably nowhere up there. I can't even answer that. Let's hear her loud and go right ahead.
Kamala Harris or Oprah Winfrey? Michelle Obama.
Why did she say ill when it came to Oprah Winfrey? Is it because she's old?
She's not my role
they probably
model.
The same age.
Who's role model is she?
Hey.
Huh?
I'm just playing.
Was Obama your role model?
Man, I loved Obama, man.
I said, was he your role model, though? I didn't ask you how you felt about him. Was he your role model? I never looked at him as my real role model.
Well, somebody,
I was happy for the man. But he wasn't my role model.
I'm happy for him. What's her name? Kamala?
Listen, that's how I know you don't even respect
Mrs. Harris, Vice President.
Yeah, you could have just said Vice President.
I mean, little black girls can grow up now and be like, oh, I could be Vice President. You know?
Well, I hate when they say
that is actually setting your standards low. Instead of saying I could be president, little black girls gonna say I could be vice president. Watch this.
Second in
charge. I could be behind a white man and he can lead and tell me what to do. I can be his servant. Watch this.
I ain't working at McDonald's.
Watch this. Wake up call. You always was behind a white man, so don't even matter.
Hey. You notice the only y'all, thing.
Hey, guess what? Y'all better stop picking on McDonald's because some of the same people who's listening to this podcast, not only do they work there, some of them about to start working there.
Hey, look, that was what I was about to say.
He said
basically, unless you're a manager, he literally told you.
And they ain't gonna be managers. Guess what, man? When this pandemic happened, and we got 1 minute left.
Okay.
When this pandemic happened, you know, in the industry I'm in, I seen a lot of quartet musicians.
Yes.
Taking pictures with their Taco Bell uniform on and their Harris Teeter's uniform on, saying, gotta do what I gotta do out here.
Give me some harmony, man. Final nails, are you ready? Yes! Give me some harmony, man. Come on, man, give me some harmony.
No, man, why are we gonna choose the violinist? It's gonna sound horrible.
Let me, because I've been thinking about doing it at home.
I like, children, are you ready? Ready for McDonald's.
Children, and I was like, are you ready?
These dudes is up until now, they gotta get a job. What happened to that woman they was like laying up with, man, who was taking care of everything?
When them folks caught, when they send the police to your house because you behind your child support, you be like, listen, I just left a McDonald's interview.
Man, guess what?
They're paying $15 an hour.
Sir, tell that to the judge.
As always, my name is I Am Quartet.
I'm Ebony.
and I am the relentless Tara, the greatest me.
Shut up.
See
hey, watch this. Haters gonna hate.
How dare you?
Haters gonna hate.
See you when we see you.
Peace.